All right, my name is Sam Staples. I'm here at the Austrian Energy Storage Conference and Exhibition with John Norman, President and CEO of Hydrostor. Now, John, I understand that Hydrostor has a very unique compressed air energy storage technology. Can you tell me a little bit about this?
Yeah, for sure. So we are pretty unique in being a bulk scale storage technology, 50 to 300 megawatts plus, really long duration, and ability to flexibly site on the grid, which is sort of a really unique niche area. And the way we do that is with compressed air. So we use engineered cavities underground and create a storage cavity whereby we can keep compressed air and actually push it up through a turbine on the surface and generate when it's needed.
Okay, now can this be sited absolutely anywhere, or are there specific geologic conditions that need to be met in order to accommodate this technology?
Yeah, I mean, the only thing we need is bedrock, which is a pretty common condition. So, yeah. I'm not going to say we can site anywhere, but we can site in the vast majority of locations. So our starting point with a grid operator is to say, where do you need this technology? Where do you have substation support that would be helpful? And we screen accordingly and we site in that location.
Okay, and where do you see the competitive benefits for compressed air energy storage versus other technologies?
Well, the great thing is we're really long duration storage. And so at a bulk scale of 300 megawatts, where we're providing 12 even greater hours of storage, we're about half the cost of batteries at that scale. And so really it's about that niche application. We're very similar to pump storage in a lot of ways, but we have the ability, as I note, to flexibly site. So that gives us a big advantage over, at that scale, being able to put it on the grid where it's required.
Okay, now I understand that thermal loss is a big issue with most compressed air energy storage technologies. How does Hydrostor combat this?
Well, we actually use a really innovative thermal storage system. So we don't burn natural gas to actually inject into a process, which is typically what compressed air has to do. We take heat from our compression process, we store it in phase change materials and sensible heat storage, and then we re-inject it back into our turbine when we're ready to generate electricity. So we sort of overcome the problem of needing this external heat source, and it's fully self-contained, emissions-free, fuel-free, and not requiring any of that type of infrastructure.
Great. Now, you mentioned that this is a large-scale energy storage technology. Is there any limit to the size, or what's the minimum size that you can install this?
Yeah, it actually depends on two types of applications. So when we're building a greenfield site in fresh bedrock, usually the minimum size we would do is about 50 megawatts. The sky is the limit in terms of sizing. We're really just building out additional void volume underground. And once we mobilize that mining infrastructure, it's actually fairly straightforward to just build that out more. We also do work with the mining industry because we can utilize their infrastructure underground, and they often have really high energy needs. We can do that at a smaller scale, so 10, 15 megawatts, even 5 megawatts. And our next project is actually in South Australia, where we're siting at a mine for a 5 megawatt application that's going to provide services to the grid.
Great. Well, John, thank you very much for joining us.
Yeah, great.